We have all seen them in the visions of a dystopian future. Swarms of machines searching the streets, hunting down a group of society that is seen as being an enemy to the state. But this is just fiction, right? It's not something we have to be worried about today. Well, it just may be. The idea of killer swarms of drones is here today, with more than one country developing the technology that could see us hiding in our homes. A swarm of high-tech monitoring devices, watching our every move, listening to everything we say, and maybe even using lethal force against us. The technology that many of those who claim to be targeted individuals say is in use today. In this video, let's take a look at mini drones and the developments being made and what this could mean for our future. Welcome to IF, videos on history and mystery. Hit that subscribe button so you never miss a video again. China is the world leader when it comes to surveillance technologies. They have the capability to monitor almost every citizen that lives in any major city. This monitoring has seen itself morph into a very secretive program that watches and indexes people's behaviors. Those that do not maintain a good score in this happiness index are carted off for re-education. Orwell must be turning in his grave. A new advancement could give the Chinese government a tool in their quest to control the population, a new robotic vehicle displayed at Airshow China Defense Expo in Zhuhai. This drone is equipped with a missile and is named the Micro-Intelligent Missile by its developers. The missile is 40mm in diameter and 500mm in length, this making it possible for it to be launched from a grenade launcher. Upon launch, it can travel to a height of 2,000m, where it prepares to launch itself at light armored targets. The weapon can also be deployed against human targets with a lethal strike radius of 12m. The platform uses an intelligent targeting system in which an operator preselects a person or vehicle to hit. The drone then uses its electro-optical system to seek and destroy its enemy. A fire-and-forget solution which could change the nature of modern combat. The Chinese are just the latest nation to join the development of this type of weapon platform. The US and others have been leaders in this field. Back in 2015, the UK government stood against an international treaty which would place a ban on killer robots. The UK's Foreign Office gave the statement saying that it saw no need for the prohibition of this classification of weapon, as international humanitarian law already regulated the area. A Foreign Office spokesman said, "The UK is not developing lethal autonomous weapon systems, and the operation of weapon systems by the UK armed forces will always be under human oversight and control." I don't know about you, but a statement like that makes me think the opposite. If they didn't have the tech, why oppose a ban? It would be more likely that they do have this technology, and that they have a large investment in the field of AI weaponry, which they don't want to lose. Allies of the United Kingdom, the US, admits that its Air Force has a selection of tiny flying bots which are capable of hovering, stalking, and even killing selected targets. AVD, the Air Vehicles Directorate, located at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, is already developing prototypes of tiny killer drones. The micro air vehicles, or MAVs for short, they are building will have a wide range of capabilities. Operating in large groups, they will form swarms of mechanical death. Each small robot armed with different payloads to complete a wide range of operations. Warheads tailored to a specific mission. Chemicals, combustibles, and explosive heads attached to each drone, which when ordered will happily kamikaze into a building, vehicle, or person. The mini drones will become an important, unobtrusive, pervasive, and lethal part of future battlefields. Micro air vehicles will enhance the capabilities of the future warfighter. The key to making this technology successful is something which is holding back many electric technologies today: battery size and power. The current batteries are limiting the operation time and distances these mini devices operate for and over. The military are working hard to accomplish their goal, and will most likely succeed with the idea of a swarm-based aerial robot which can be dropped from planes, monitor, or invade an area. Working as a single entity, these units will be able to simultaneously monitor the broad view of a battlefield as well as individual targets. The MEVs will be capable of making decisions on how to best strike, what ordnance would be best suited, and the optimal path of approach. This data would be sent and received by the entire hive of MAVs in real time. It would be extremely reliable and allow the drones to carry out decisions which they would then send back to their operators. This technology has implications that extend further than the battlefields of the future. People have long relied on masks and other disguises to hide their identities, but these MAVs will be fitted with the latest advanced vision techniques, which will easily see through the mask worn by criminals, or maybe even protesters. This will allow those in control to identify and possibly even tag or take action against these people remotely. This indicates a huge shift in the ability of a small group of people to control a populace. The temptation presented by this technology could be too much for governments, dictators, or despots to resist. We can see the path this is heading down with China and also India. The government of India has funded a team of scientists from Cambridge University to develop an algorithm which will be able to identify people who have obscured their faces by wearing hats and sunglasses, fake beards and scarves. These drones could already be in use. If you have watched the videos on targeted individuals linked above, you will know that some say they are. These MAVs could be spying on us today, and they would be extremely difficult to spot. The size aside, the builders of this technology are looking to nature for designs and are creating drones which could easily be mistaken for insects or birds. The US military patterned its drone after a hawk moth. It even has wings that are capable of flapping over 30 times a second. Another drone is like a pigeon and perches unobtrusively on power lines to observe a surveillance target with its camera. A camera which one can assume would have facial recognition software that I just mentioned. The Air Force is working on technology that will allow the drones to leech electricity from power lines or other sources, this allowing them to operate for days, weeks, or months on end. These drones will also not need to be connected to the internet or GPS satellites, this removing the vulnerability to hacks. They will use advanced sensors or optic flow. This will allow them to fly by sight, just like a real animal. It also eliminates the problem with GPS signals, which can be disrupted by buildings or deliberately jammed by enemy forces. A film made by Future Life Institute, FLI, presents a chilling and maybe soon-to-be situation with footage of a mass slaughter being carried out by tiny drones. The drones featured in the project named Slaughterbots. They use facial recognition to identify their targets before blasting them in the skull. If we consider other abilities which scientists are developing to use with AI and robotics, we get something truly terrifying. Scientists have developed the technology to give robots self-healing properties which allow them to recover from damage. We are at a shifting point in warfare. Elon Musk and Mustafa Suleiman, the founders of Tesla and Alphabet's DeepMind AI unit, stepped forward and warned us that an urgent ban is needed. This is to prevent a third revolution in warfare. This after the big changes caused by the creation of gunpowder and nuclear arms. It will only take one major war to unleash these new weapons with tragic humanitarian consequences and destabilization of global security. Do you think we face a future when we will be watched and stalked by these electronic surveillance insects? Do you think this will be a good thing, providing extra security? Will this technology be used to crush the last of humanity's freedoms and privacy? Let me know in the comments below. If you like what we do here on the channel, hit that subscribe button, like and share. You can catch the latest by searching We Are If. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.